Hi and welcome to my first video in this series about microorganisms and health. So the first thing we're going to look at are the types of things which can cause disease. And so the first of these are microorganisms. And so there are three main types. There are fungi, bacteria and viruses. And you can see here, this diagram they've got at the top, this shows us that of the three of these, the largest is fungi, the next largest is bacteria, and the next largest is viruses. Now, these measurements that you have here corresponding to this virus are nanometers. Now, if we divide up a meter, we can divide up a meter into millimeters, and then subsequently micrometers, and then into nanometers. A nanometer is basically a meter divided into a billion. So if you imagine 1 meter divided into a billion parts, that can be, in some cases, a smallpox virus is about 200 nanometers long or wide, and therefore it's particularly small. So bacteria are a type of microorganism that require basically a couple of things in order to grow. Usually they need a food source, and they need a source of moisture and heat. And they can grow in a number of different environments. One way to culture or grow bacteria is to grow them on what's known as an agar plate, which is what's shown here. The agar provides the bacteria with food so it can colonise and it can multiply. Viruses, on the other hand, are slightly different. What viruses do is they work by infecting host cells, and that can be bacterial cells, that can be human cells, and they use the mechanisms within the cells in order to reproduce. So there is a term that we can use to describe microorganisms that means they cause disease, and that word is pathogenic. So a microorganism that causes a disease is sometimes referred to as a pathogen. Now we've got some examples of pathogens here. So types of fungus that cause disease, athlete's foot and thrush. Specifically, the one that causes thrush is called candida. Viruses that are pathogenic are the smallpox and flu. And bacterial infections, which are pathogenic, are tuberculosis and cholera. What this means is not all microorganisms are bad for you, not all of them cause disease, but the few that do are referred to as pathogens. There are also other types of diseases that are not caused by pathogens, and these are lifestyle diseases, things like heart disease and lung cancer. Those things are caused by our environmental choices. So for instance, people who smoke are at a much bigger risk of lung cancer. And so we have lifestyle and pathogenic diseases. Now, I said previously about bacteria, they require these several things to grow, so warmth, food and water. And basically, bacteria grow by dividing and making copies of themselves. And so what can happen is if you start off with one cell or a single bacteria that finds a food source, that can then multiply and reproduce to produce two cells, and then those two cells reproduce each, and they produce four, and then so on to 8, 16, 32, 64. And so if we looked at, if this graph shows us the growth rate of a colony of bacteria, it shows that them increasing at an exponential rate. Exponential means this type of relationship here, where it doubles very, very quickly, and so the numbers can increase rapidly. And so in order for bacteria to grow, they need warmth, food and water. And if any of those resources run out, you get what's happening here. So where the growth rate slows down rapidly and it plateaus. And then eventually what will happen is, because of the lacking of one of these three resources, the number of bacteria tend to go down very, very rapidly. So, for instance, if we looked at a bacterial colony that might colonise some dead or some vegetable peelings, then because they have an adequate food source, their numbers will rise very, very quickly. But as that food source begins to run out, the bacteria numbers begin to drop very, very rapidly because the resources run out. So in summary, diseases can be caused by microorganisms or lifestyle factors. In the case of lifestyle factors, these are diseases like heart disease or lung cancer. So of microorganisms, there are three types, fungi being the largest, the next largest are bacteria, and the smallest are viruses. Not all microorganisms are actually dangerous. Some of them are beneficial. But the ones that do cause disease are referred to as pathogens. When bacteria colonise a given area, then they require three things: food, warmth and water. And if any of those three things run out, then the bacterial colony will reduce in size.